Hello. We're here on the set of The Fosters this afternoon. We're going to be interviewing Sherri Saum, Teri Polo, Maya Mitchell, David Lambert, and Sierra Ramirez. Very fabulous cast. Here we're on the set of Mike's Bachelor Pad. And it's going to be a very lovely day. So hold on to your hats, strap yourselves in. We're going for a ride.
Well, obviously, the end of the first part of the season was a big moment with that kiss and your wedding.
Mm-hmm.
So how are we picking up with Steph and Lena when we come back?
We are picking up literally the very next morning where we wake up. Of course, there is no honeymoon. Who has honeymoons anymore these days? Life always gets a little too complicated. And we do find out that, you saw at the end of the episode that Callie has taken off. And we spend our time trying to find her. We're, of course, very concerned and very sad and very upset. There's a lot of guilt running around with a few of our children. A lot of confusion. Lena and Steph are confused because we want to adopt them. We want them to be a part of our family. And we're confused as to why she would do such a thing.
Because as we knew it, everything was wonderful. And, you know, we thought we really had our family coming together finally. So it's going to kind of begin the odyssey of Callie and trying to find out why she left, where she went to, and trying to put everything back together again.
But it's interesting because, you know, you get to see into the minds, and this is why I love our writers, because it's a very realistic portrayal, I think, of a teenager of this age not realizing the ramifications of her actions, not only through the kiss, but by running away. She thinks that she's being selfless. Jude calls her selfish, but in her mind, she feels that she's being selfless and is trying to do something for her brother because she loves him. And it's a true look into the mind of a teenager and what they would do, what they think that would be the best thing. And it's not all that melodramatic, and it's not all that unbelievable. It's real. It's real life. It's things that decisions that teenagers would make to. So we spend our time trying to find her because we love her and we want to bring her back. Of course, there are ramifications for your actions. That's what we try to teach our children in the show. That's what I try to teach my children.
How is that going to affect him coming into this season? Does he feel guilty? Does he feel sad? Like how?
He's very angry at his sister leaving him, but at the same time, he's also very sad that she is gone, and he's always had her. He's never really had a family, but he's always had his sister. So he's angry at Brandon because he thinks that, you know, he's the reason she ran away, but he's also very sad that he might not get to be with her. So, you know, he really is starting to show a lot more emotion towards the family and towards Callie. But, I mean, he still does love his sister, and he still does want to be with her. And he is still this quiet kid, but now he's starting to really show that he has all these feelings and he's really expressing those to everybody.
So how will this affect all the relationships in the house with Callie being gone? Will certain characters get closer? Will they fight more?
It affects every one of other characters. There are some characters, like I said, that feel remarkably guilty. Jude feels guilty for what he said, although he still kind of stands by his feelings. Brandon, of course, feels guilty and confused because he does love her and doesn't want her to go away. But at the same time, he feels as if it's his fault that he kissed her. And it puts a bit of a strain on our newly wedded marriage about did we do the right thing? Did we not do the right thing? Should we have trusted her? Should we not have trusted her? Jesus and Mariana... Jesus and Mariana are always off in their own worlds and doing their things that just are like, what are you guys doing? Come back here. God love them. They're teenagers. But yeah, it puts a great deal of throws confusion into the house. But as always, we do our best as parents to kind of, you know, rein it in and do the best we can.
How are his relationships going to blossom with the other members of the family?
He really starts to grow a relationship with Mariana because she kind of fills that sister need for him. You know, she steps in and plays the sister, and he really enjoys having her. Jesus is kind of like, you know, whatever. He kind of does his own stuff. And Brandon, he's still not very sure about. But he really does warm up to Mariana, and he warms up to everybody. But Mariana really kind of becomes that big sister for him.
What is something that you're excited for fans to see with Lena coming up?
Lena has a lot of self-discovery going on in this next part of the season. You know, your kids really challenge you, and they, in times of struggle, it really reveals character and reveals who you are and what you really want out of life. So she does a lot of questioning just about, you know, certain things that she may want or may not want in her life, and she has to explore those things and face them.
Is there anything that's coming up for Steph that you're most excited for fans to see this season?
I can't really say because I don't want to give anything away. Teri Polo is very excited about the whole second half of the season, period. You know, the first half of the season, we all worked our butts off because we all knew what we had. We all knew it was heart and soul and love and respect for each other as people. Producers and writers were portraying their stories, their lives. So for me, it was incredibly important to get things right, to honor what they have written for us and given us in these characters. Now with I'm having lovely critical acclaim, having fantastic ratings and an extraordinary fan base, and being picked up already for a second season without having finished our first season. I can only speak for myself and say that I feel as if I'm trying to get my sea legs and hunker down, because I'm a little heady, thinking, wow, I'm so proud and I'm so honored, and I'm so in awe of the fact that we are touching and reaching people and helping people to understand and to learn and to comprehend that it's just about love, no matter who you are, size, shape, gender, sexual orientation, you know. So I feel like I'm trying to get my sea legs and really hunker down and maintain the integrity and quality of the work that we had in the first half of the season, to make sure that it's just as good and just as worthy of people's attention and love, because we are getting as much love, I think, back as we're trying to put into the show.
I love that in the first half of the season we did get to see some flashbacks, like when how you guys met and everything. Are we going to get any more flashbacks?
We haven't filmed any flashbacks this part of the season yet, but I know that they were a really big hit with fans and with us as well. It's fun to see where these characters come from. So I have a feeling they might try to work that in more.
Is there
so much
certain one that you would love to see? Like, whether it's like what happened to Callie before she came to you?
I would love to see Callie, you know, the beginnings of Callie and Jude's story. More with Lena, maybe. I don't know. I just, anything that they want to dig into, I think I'm game, because it's just so much fun and it only adds more, you get more invested in these characters.
The show has resonated with a lot of people of all ages and all kinds. Have you heard any great fan messages from people that have reached out to you and been like, I love what you're doing?
I have. I've heard some people say that they really connect with the show. I've had some people say that they really connect with Jude, how they're also quiet and bullied and how they come from the foster system, and it's very touching to hear that. And also it's great to hear people who say that it makes a difference and that it really makes them happy. And some people say that they aren't afraid to be different since Jude showed them. So, I mean, it's amazing, and it feels great to have people really love the show and really love what Jude does. And it's really cool.
I do get recognized sometimes. And I'm new to Twitter. I've been doing it in the last year, and it's been amazing. And I really expected a lot more bashing and negative comments, but I've just gotten nothing but love and support and these really enthusiastic fans. And but I got a couple of letters, which is new and so old-fashioned, but really nice that someone sat and put pen to paper and got a stamp. And you know, and they tell you how much the show has affected their lives, or that we are portraying what they live every day. That is so meaningful to me.
It's remarkable, because I have had, I was back east, I'm back from back east originally. I was back east this past summer, and I had teenage girls coming up to me screaming and crying as if I was a Beatle, and I know that might be a little bit of an old reference for some of you youngsters. Like I was Beyonce, is that better? And then their little 9 and 10 and 11 year old brothers would say, we like it too. And then I would have mid-40-year-old women stopping me in the supermarket and saying, oh my God, we love your show. Grandparents saying that they watch it with their grandchildren and it's wonderful. So it's touching everybody because I think that there's an aspect to this because it is about family and love, period, ultimately at the end of the day. And my own personal story, I had done a function over the weekend, gotten a free purse for Sherri, and I was so excited to bring it to her on Monday morning. And I'm walking out the door Monday morning, 5 o'clock, to get into my car, and my daughter, who will be 6 in a few days, comes running out in her footy pajamas carrying the purse, and she says, mommy, you forgot the purse for your wife, as if it was normal. And this is the generation, these are the generations that we're raising, because this is now, this is life, this is love, no matter what. And it just made me feel so proud. I drove just to work the first couple of minutes crying, thinking, we've done our job. We are changing the minds and the views and the opinions of generations to come, so that this is what it is, period. This is life.